Hello, beautiful people. If you can hear me, do me a solid right now and just let me know in the chat so that I know that you can hear me and I know that you're good to go. And I will get started. I just need somebody to let me know. Beautiful. Let me see. Thank you, guys. Thank you. All right. As long as one can hear, usually everybody can hear. Welcome. Welcome to Care Less, Do More, Be a Badass. Now, this workshop that I'm presenting today is a little kind of left of where I would usually present. Usually I'm all about heart space, feeling into what is at the base of your being and really tuning into your soul. And this workshop, it's kind of a different feel, I suppose. I come out a little stronger with this one. And I know a lot of you that have registered to do this workshop with me today haven't done a workshop with me before. And so I felt like this was a nice way to ease you into this communication, to the conversation that we're going to start without being too weird, to be honest. Because I do give myself permission within these workshops to tap into your subconscious. A lot of us know what we know. We're aware there are things that we don't know. But beyond that, there are things that we have not even considered, contemplated, or brought into our consciousness before. And a lot of what I create and present aims to confuse you, aims to disrupt you, aims to get you to think in a way that you have never considered before. This workshop, it's not so challenging. And so I feel like you will be able to follow. You will be able to understand what I'm trying to say. And your aim today is just to feel into it all. When you feel yourself nodding and you feel yourself agreeing, consider, what is it about this that I'm resonating with and relating to? When you feel yourself push back and think, ugh, no, that's not right. That doesn't feel right. That is something that you really need to lean into as well. So just tune in. Be aware of the sensations within your body. Bring some consciousness to what you are thinking and what you are feeling. And just enjoy the opportunity to take an hour to reflect on who you are, who you are choosing to be, and who you might be able to become if you care less, do more, and decide to be a badass. Yes, good. We're doing it. We are. So we need to have a conversation today about how important it is as women to make a decision, a declaration, to stop caring more about what other people think than what we think. The problem is we are raised to be empathetic. We're praised when we're being kind, when we're behaving, when we're being a good girl, right? If we're taking care of others and nurturing and being considerate and being sensitive, these are all things that we are praised for. And as grown-ass women, yes, we can still very much care about what other people think, but not at the cost of spending time and getting to truly understand what it is that we think. And so this is what this conversation is about today. It's not saying actually don't care about others, or don't remain insightful or sensitive or tuned in to the energies of others. But it is a reminder that you should be firstly tuned into what exactly it is you think. That needs to come first. I wanted to begin today by sharing a poem with you. It's fucking powerful and I'm excited to share it with you. And I'm actually going to be sharing most of the presentations I do moving forward with this reading. It is called An Invitation to Brave Space, and it's written by Mickey Scott B. Jones, and it is powerful and it is beautiful. Now, I used to say that I created safe space for women, and I no longer say that. I use the term brave space. So when I came across this poem and I read the words and it resonated so deeply with me, I've made it my mission to share it with as many women as possible. So let me begin today. Invitation to Brave Space. Together, we will create brave space because there is no such thing as a safe space. We exist in the real world. We all carry scars and we have all caused wounds. In this space, we seek to turn down the volume of the outside world. We amplify voices that fight to be heard elsewhere. We call each other to more truth and love. We have the right to start somewhere and continue to grow. We have the responsibility to examine what we think we know. We will not be perfect. This space will not be perfect. It will not always be what we wish it to be, but it will be our brave space together, and we will work on it side by side. I wanted to offer that to you today, and I wanted just to take a moment for you to fully acknowledge the fact that you are taking this time today for yourself to tune into this, to be part of this dialogue, to be part of this conversation. I want you to really acknowledge what that says about you, how that feels. And I want to thank you for joining me in this brave space and being open to conversations like this. So as humans, we are wired for connection, right? Our primal brains are wired for connection. And we go about our lives kind of unaware that we have this desperate need for inclusion. Oh, excuse me, guys. Phone ringing. A desperate need for inclusion. And this is where our problems start to begin, right? In order to do things in your life that you want to do in a way that feels like the truest, most authentic expression of who you are, we need to be willing to care less about what others do, what other people think. Tune into what we believe, what we want, what we desire, what we can see for ourselves, and actually do things. Most of us, if you've been compelled to listen to something that encourages you to be a badass, it's because we are interested in or curious about or drawn towards concepts that are innovative, right? Or we want to have thoughts, expressions, ideas, create and cause things of quality. We're not here just to replicate. We know we are here to create and cause things within our lives, right? And to do that, if you are going to create change within yourself, within your life, if you're going to experience yourself in a new way, if you're going to create or cause anything, small or big, initially, what you actually have to commit to is being okay with being unrelatable and misunderstood. That's the first step. And that is usually the first hurdle that most people can't seem to get over, right? To be unrelatable and misunderstood is quite a confronting thing. But if you are truly seeking to be the authentic expression of who you are, uniquely you, tapped into your soul's purpose and here to put the energetic signature on things only you can create, there's no roadmap for that. There's actually no signpost to tell you where to go. Your life is an evolution of you figuring this out for yourself by tuning into who you are, what is meant for you, what is best for you, what is true for you. There is no one that has the answers for you. It's you that has to get up every day, open your eyes, be awake, and discover. Now, this can be really confronting for a lot of people. And for most people, before they do something, before they set a goal, before they set a target for themselves, before they make any sort of declaration, they feel like they truly have to know who they are. And in doing that, I suppose, is what they are hoping to be able to generate is a sense of confidence. If I know who I am, then I know whether I'm capable of creating, causing, doing that thing. I own a gym, and I've recently just launched a beginner's running program. 10 weeks supporting people in making small gains in upping their level of fitness and their capacity and capability to run. And when I offered this program to people, the overwhelming response is, oh, I'm not a runner. And I have to hold myself back from laughing and saying, well, I know that. That's why this is a running program for beginners, right? Most people hold themselves back from finding out what they are ever capable of doing based on who they believe themselves to be today. So if you are going to create and cause things that only you can do, only you can do because it is your soul's purpose and it is the unique energetic signature you are here in this world to leave on everything that you do, you are going to have to stand in your own power and work this out yourself. And in order to do that, you have to stop caring about what other people think of you when you were trying to step out and doing amazing things in your life. Because not everybody takes the brave, courageous steps of generating change, of living authentically. And when we do something that is even slightly different from what the collective have declared is safe and secure, they'll say to you, what are you doing? Are you sure you want to do that? Do you know if you can do that? And we have to tune into our own inner knowing and tune out all of that resistance, hesitation, and negativity that is going to be fired at us. So, at any point in your life, you can actually decide to reintroduce yourself, to others, in any context that you want to. Because the truth is, you get to decide what to believe about yourself. I do a whole workshop on self-belief and the magic that is found in realizing that our beliefs are just a series of thoughts that we have had on repeat for so long that we have decided that they are true. But actually, we get to choose to believe anything that we want. So you can actually give yourself full permission, and I encourage you to give yourself full permission every day and wake up and consider yourself completely new, ready, capable, willing to discover more about who you are and to become the truest expression of yourself. That is badass. In order to evolve and grow and become more of who we are, we can't simply replicate what it is that we did yesterday, what we thought, how we felt, what we did. What was acceptable for us yesterday can be completely irrelevant to us today if that is what we choose for ourselves. At any moment in time, you could decide that you are going to be a completely different person with new thoughts, new beliefs, taking new actions, and there is no one that could actually stop you. So let me slow down a little and take a second to just really clarify what I believe a badass is. And it's important, I suppose, for you to have your own definition. So for me, a badass is someone that does what she wants, where she wants, when she wants. She's dedicated to evolving and being the greatest version of herself. She isn't apologizing, she isn't compromising, and she doesn't give up. And she relentlessly pursues her goals. A badass is anything she damn well wants to be. Now, I have a picture of Madonna here because I consider her to be a badass. She allowed herself to evolve. There were so many iterations of who she was, what she created, what she looked like, what she was out to cause, what she believed. And why not? And why not? She didn't need permission from anybody else to express herself in a new way, right? You have that same power. Who you have always been, who your family has considered you to be, the role you have played within society does not dictate who you can become in this moment. We have freedom of choice. You have free will. If you can align your soul's purpose with free will and authentically express what is meant for you, what you feel at the base of your being, and use that as the compass to start guiding your choices and the decisions and the declarations you make, life just kind of opens up for you. It's when we get stuck in the roles that we think we have to fulfill because it's what we have been led to believe we have to do, that we start to feel like life is kind of monotonous, a little bit autopilot, a little bit Groundhog Day, predictable in a way that doesn't actually feel safe and secure, but just kind of gray. And that's not what we want from this one beautiful life that we have. So I'm encouraging you to consider what is actually stopping you from stepping into your own power, right? I have, as a grown-ass woman, claimed my own power. I'm unapologetic about the fact that I believe I'm capable of doing, achieving, causing, and creating anything that I set my mind to, right? And it is because I have been able to create and deliver results in my own life, in pretty much every area of my life, that it makes me really motivated to do more, to teach more, to show more, to be more in a space of creation. I look at my business. I run a gym with my husband in the past year. And I really do feel like 2020 makes me a fucking badass. We were talking about it last night. We were running a business that was shut down for 9 months out of a 12-month period, and yet we managed to grow. It was actually the best financial year we've had since we opened, because I made the decision that I was going to use this opportunity to create online products, to grow a bigger presence, to deliver things online, that I was not going to be beaten just by a change of circumstance, that my vision for who I was as a business owner would not be dictated by circumstance. That's badass, right? Of course. And it all comes down to self-belief, right? When you are stepping into a place that you want badass results, then you need to have the skill set and the practice at being able to set badass goals and being a badass. It's simple as that. It's not just a thought. It's not just a feeling. It's a way of being. So let's talk about that. You get to just make the decision to be badass in this life. To not be tentative, to not be scared, to not be hesitant, right? That's just not who you are. You decide to know yourself as a badass. And what does that mean? It means you know that you are the creator of everything that you experience, every thought you have, every feeling you experience, every sensation you feel. Anything that is in front of you, you have actually put it there by the decisions, the actions, the choices that you have made in your past. You are the creator of your entire reality, right? And so if you're going to be badass, what this means is that you need to have badass goals and decide that even if you fail along the way, you'll be going after them with all your heart and spirit and energy and work relentlessly to just blow your own mind. A badass sets the goal but doesn't worry whether it is achievable or not. They just go. They trailblaze. Remember, they're not replicating. They're creating something new. It's a completely different feeling. It's a way of being, not a result. We don't consider ourselves a badass based on what we produce. It's the way of being, the energy, the vibration, yeah, that makes somebody a badass. Are you following? I hope so. I hope you're nodding. I hope this is lighting a fire within you to think, fuck yes, yes. This is what I can be. This is what I can choose for myself. This is how life can feel. Exciting, expansive. Now, at this point, I think it's worth saying that you don't have to be arrogant, and you probably shouldn't be arrogant in order to be a badass. There's a difference, okay? We all know somebody who is arrogant, right? That talks a big game, talks probably a little bit too much, and we consider them to be arrogant. And I think that is very different. There's a distinction between someone who is arrogant and someone who is badass, right? So there's a few things we can explore here. And the first is that misery loves company, okay? Being able to pull the victim card usually guarantees inclusion, okay? So to be a badass, firstly, you have to know that you are not ever going to allow yourself to be a victim of circumstance or just anything, right? Because when you do, when you complain, when you whinge, when you find things that are wrong in the world to talk about, you will find company. You will find other people that will agree with you. Misery loves company. The collective, right, is more committed to pointing out what they can criticize than actually taking on the role of creator, okay? So as a badass, one of the things that you have to develop is your capacity to talk about yourself in a way that celebrates who you are so that people can enjoy and celebrate that with you, right? A badass learns the skill and develops the confidence to love themselves out loud, to celebrate their achievements, to celebrate their experiences, just to celebrate the day that they are in. And it's not arrogance, because when you are badass, your self-love is never at the expense of anyone else, okay? When you have a badass mindset, you will have a radar for people that are not quite on your level of expansion, Okay. You'll be put off when people are celebrating themselves while trying to convince you that they are better than someone else. Okay. That kind of talk, that kind of thinking, that comes from insecurity. It's trying to prove something, right? People that put other people down are only doing that to make themselves feel better. I think we all understand that. So being badass is never saying that I am greater than, I am better than, right? No. It's about being the fullest expression of yourself. I am the greatest is a mindset that you can take on for yourself. And in a weird way, I suppose what I'm encouraging is accepting your own mediocrity, acknowledging and accepting and actually loving it, right? When we as individuals can recognize that there is nothing special about us, right? There is nothing actually that special about us as an individual. We all have the capacity to be the greatest versions of ourselves, to create what we want from our deep driving desires. Each individual has the right to experience themselves and their life in a way that feels like the fullest expression of who they are and what they are here to experience. We can each be the greatest. Okay. And it doesn't take away from the next person being the greatest and experiencing themselves in that way. There is no competition. I am the greatest is not up for debate. When I say that for myself, to myself, as a way of being every day, I am the greatest. I am unapologetic about that. And I am unconcerned about whether you believe that to be true about me or not. That's badass. You need to focus on yourself. You could do that for yourself too. Take on an abundance mindset that as you evolve and you expand and you become the greatest expression of who you are giving everybody else permission around you to do the same. You show what's possible and you communicate in a way that people can hear you and see what's possible. It's not bragging. Saying you love yourself, you love your life, you love the work that you do, that's not bragging. There will be people that can't hear you or choose to hear what they want to. Do you anyway? So being a badass is a pretty simple process, but it's a daily decision that you have to make. In order to be badass, you keep showing up in a way that creates strength in your mind and in your body, right? So I think you need to honor your needs and strengthen your devotion to the things that you need to do that help you evolve daily to be the highest version of yourself, the greatest vibration, the energy that you choose to generate and radiate to come from within needs to be supported by daily rituals. This is work that I do with women very specifically to help them access and activate what is at the base of their being and make sure that that is brought forward in all that they do every day. You need to be supported. You need to get a coach. There is so much that we need to unpack from within us based on our lived experiences, our values, our beliefs. We need to really understand what is going on within us before we can ever have a different experience within the world around us. You can't do that alone. You can't. I'm unapologetic about saying that. Anyone that I know that has experienced success in any area of their life, business, personal life, sport, whatever you want, they all have mentors, coaches, teachers, somebody that has helped them evolve forward. And then you also need to know the difference between understanding and implementing. This is something I'm so passionate about talking about. So many women will tell me about the books that they read and the podcasts that they listen to, even the meditation practices that they do. And yet nothing changes in their life because they don't actually implement anything effectively or consistently or with clarity. So if you can get these three pieces of the puzzle to come together, you become badass pretty much immediately, right? Honoring your needs and strengthening your devotion to them. Note, I will highlight that used to say, honor your needs and strengthen your discipline. And I have changed my approach. I have changed my languaging because for me, words like discipline, schedule, structure, rigidity, right? Ugh, it just makes me feel like I don't know, repressed, denied, held back. So the language that I choose to use for myself and share with you in this space is supposed to feel expansive, loving, abundant. And so that's why that word is there. Get supported, get a coach, know the difference between understanding and implementing. I'm going to come back to what I was saying before about badasses not playing the victim card and not feeling sorry for themselves. They own what they create, good or bad, and they own the way creation happens around them rather than talking about how it happens to them, right? So a badass takes full responsibility and accountability for everything that they are experiencing within their reality. And I have a picture of my husband here. His name is Steve Moxon. He's a professional fighter, two-time world champion. And he is an example of badassery, not just in the ring, but just in the way that he holds himself and moves through life. And it's been really fascinating for me to see the way that he cultivates a sense of self and the ripple effect that that has in the way that people interact with him. So he shows up in a way that is confident and well-prepared. He's a man who knows who he is. His boundaries are clearly in place. His values defined, right? He's well thought out, well put together. And that's an important consideration to have if you want to show up in a badass way. If you are not going to be a person that wobbles or is confronted by circumstance or that feels like they are at the mercy of people around them, right? They might have a tendency to shapeshift to fit in with the crowd, yeah? You need to have very, very strong connection to who you are, what you believe, what matters most to you. And to be a tough, uncompromising person, you need to generate determined energy, okay? Being prepared for your life and being thoughtful about the way you show up in the world will create a reaction from people. And I see this in Steve all the time. So a silly example that I have is when we're walking through a shopping center, you know, in the middle of shopping centers, sometimes there are people trying to sell certain products and they want to give you a little sample of it. They'll say to you, can I just ask you a quick question? And they pull people into that moment, right? They distract them from wherever they were going, whatever their intention was, and pull them into their, their agenda, right? What I notice with Steve is the people that are selling these things, right, looking for an opportunity to capture people's attention and pull them into their space, will see Steve and be too intimidated to approach him. They can see that he is a man who has a force field of energy around him that is so aligned to who he is, where he is going, what his purpose is in that day, that they never, ever dare to even say hello. I'll watch them try and talk to the five people walking ahead of him, and then they say nothing to him. Steve is the sweetest, kindest, most friendly man I have ever met in my life, and yet his energy in that moment radiates a sense of authority, a sense of self, a sense of you cannot fuck with me that people are just aware of. You don't get to generate energy or have experiences with people or radiate a certain sense of self without first doing the inner work to be really clear on who you are, what matters most to you, and what you believe. And when you have complete clarity around who you are, what you believe, what matters to you, then you just walk with your shoulders back, your chest up, your chin held high, and a smile on your face, because the world becomes your playground rather than feeling like you are at the mercy of the energies around you. This is an important distinction to make. Who you are and how other people relate to you is mostly generated by the way that you show up in the world. And how you show up in the world isn't what role you do, what job you do, what car you drive. No, no. It's how you think about yourself and how that makes you feel in any moment that you are in. So if you want to be badass, and I know that you do because life is more fun when you decide that you are, you just need to make decisions, because all your power comes from your decisions. All of your big decisions that you make for yourself actually come from the little decisions. That's the way it works. That's the way we take action, make progress, create and cause things in our lives. We make a big decision And then we make tiny little decisions about everything that you have to do to bring that to reality, right? And the decisions that you make about what you will do when you fail, when you stumble, when things get challenging. So you make the big decision about what you are out to create and cause, and then you make hundreds of little decisions in the process on your way about what that means for you in the moment you are in. It's all the little decisions that you can make, and the faster you can make decisions for yourself, because you know yourself, you trust yourself, right? The faster you generate momentum. And the more momentum you build, the easier it is to just be more of who you are. We don't constantly feel like we're trying to like start our motor day after day. We are motoring along, driven by who we know we are, what we are out to cause, what we want to create. Life feels really fun when you're living in that way. The other thing a badass will do is take failure as a sign of growth. You can just decide in this moment that failure is a concept that doesn't frighten you. It doesn't hold you back. You are completely fucking open to it. That if you fail at something, if you fall short at something, if you make a mistake, then that's cool. I really love this concept, because if it doesn't matter if you succeed or fail, right? You know, you can still just go out and do things, and that the real power comes from generating the power and the growth from the decisions that you have made. Our biggest mistakes are often our biggest lessons, right? It's not the first time you have heard that, excuse me, getting ahead of myself, trying to stick to time. If failing is something that you accept for yourself and you actually welcome, and you just decide that you don't believe that failure is a negative thing, and failure doesn't say anything about your capacity or your capability to continue, then you go out into the world ready to create and cause without fear, without hesitation, without resistance, willing for the opportunity to learn and grow and move through things, right? We have the capacity to do this. It's just that life has beaten it out of us. Society has told us that failing, making mistakes, right, is something that we should feel shame about. When you look at children, small children, I look at my son as a perfect example, right? Toddlers, when they're learning to walk, will fall down a million times. They don't do it right the first time. No one actually gives them a manual and says, okay, this is how you walk. You're going to bend here. You're going to put your foot forward here. You're going to look here. There's no manual for that, right? They just decide within their own time to try. And they try and they keep going and they fall and they keep learning and they build the success and the strength that comes when you just don't give up. When a child is learning to walk, even when they fall 100 times, we don't say to them, look, I don't think this is working out for you. Maybe just stay crawling, right? And no one doubts their capacity to actually build the strength and the skill to do the thing that they have set out to do. You have that capacity in you as a human to set your sights on something and decide that this is what I am going to achieve, experience, create, or cause, no matter how many times you fall along the way, no matter how long it takes you, no matter what you experience. Failure is okay and part of the process. When you can just take that on for yourself, you become unstoppable. So I'm going to encourage you from this point forward to consider whether you could fail like a badass. Being a badass does not mean that you won't fail. It actually means you are willing to fail. You are willing to be crushed and keep moving forward. You're willing to put yourself in harm's way, to take risks, get up earlier, work out harder, show up longer, claim things that others won't, whatever it means for you in whatever context you find yourself in. We all have this in us. We can all be uncompromising and deliberate if we decide to be. We need to understand that consistency doesn't require motivation. We don't have to feel a sense of motivation to do things consistently, right? We just make decisions for what we want for ourselves, who we choose to know ourselves as, and show up and serve our higher self through that devotion every single day. We create rituals that help us activate and amplify the things that we need to remind ourselves of so that we can be all that we are able to be and go out into the world fully expressed. It's badass. If you are not doing that, if you are not living like that, I'd like you to just take a moment and ask yourself why. What is it that makes you hesitate? What is it that makes you turn down the volume on who you are, what you have to say, what you want to express, what you want to be? Usually it's some lived experience that we have been through, something that we've been told, something we've witnessed, something we've experienced, and we've internalized that and created rules around who we can be and what we can and can't do. But remember, I said, what you choose to believe is always up for negotiation. And you could decide to believe something completely new in any moment. I also like to just mention that being a badass doesn't mean that you think you're flawless, right? Before I, you know, said very passionately, I am the greatest, and I fucking believe that I am the greatest expression of myself that I can be today. But it doesn't mean that I think that I'm flawless. I know I have a fuck ton of faults and I don't try and downplay any of them, right? Where I need to strengthen them and where I don't, I'm aware of and I accept that. You don't have to be perfect. Actually, nobody likes the perfectionists, right? Each one of us as individuals has areas of strength that we can build on and share and contribute with. And then there are other areas that, you know, might be considered our downfall, and that's okay. We get to own that. We can just accept that truth and maybe even just delegate things out, right? Or pass it to somebody else that, you know, can support us with that. Excuse me. Oh, I've been on calls for most of the day, my poor throat. So as a badass, I don't want you to deny what you're good at any longer. When there's an opportunity for you to contribute, to be, to give, to express, you do that at 100% of your capacity. You don't hide it. And similarly, if there's something that you're struggling with that you're not great at, right? That's just not your strength. Don't hide that and bury that in shame. Own that too. Excuse me, guys. I'm just going to see if I can mute for a second, have a big cough. Give me 1 second. All right. So, a willingness to fail and a willingness to make clear decisions quickly and effectively, that you don't overthink, that you don't go backwards and forwards on, that you're not trying to get everybody else's opinion on, is a characteristic that you can claim for yourself. And I have some questions that you might like to take on as inquiry questions. That means there's no one actual answer that comes up. An inquiry question is something that you can take on and let the answer evolve. Let it come through you. It's not a right or wrong answer. It's not a this is what I think in this moment, so this is the right answer. It's something that you just allow to kind of be in your consciousness and to consider and think about. So some questions that I have for you today. Where can I see that I'm already a badass? We all have things that we have done, experienced, given, created that makes us pretty badass. Things that we go like, yes, that was pretty awesome. I was in my full power. I didn't let other people dictate to me who I could be, what I should do. That was badass. Acknowledge that within yourself. The next question, where have I already created badassery? Okay. Where do I want to see more of it? And where do I want to show up in a way that is creative and disciplined / devoted and strong? Decide. Sit with those questions and then decide. Decide what it is that you want to experience within yourself. And if you did, what that could create and cause within your life, within your lived experience. That's the end of this conversation today, guys. That was just a little taste test, a little sample of the way that I kind of present and work with women. And in June, I'm launching a 6-week weight loss mindset transformation program. This is the work of my heart. This is a deep dive into your mindset. And it's not just for women who feel like they have a lot of weight to lose. It's for women who don't quite understand what holds them back from being able to just fully embody the truest expression of who they are. If you are someone who does not feel like they are living in their body with effortless ease, this is a program for you. If you're caught up in your head, if you're dictated by who you should be, and your decisions for yourself and your life are often influenced by what other people are going to think and what you think is the right thing to do, this is a program that's going to get you to the source of what holds you back. We're going to uncover your beliefs, your values. We're going to deeply examine your tendencies and the behaviors that you have that are creating ripple effects into all areas of your life. And then once you understand who you are, why you do the things you do, you'll be given the opportunity to make new decisions for yourself and design a future that is reflective of what is truly at the base of your being. We uncover your needs and your desires, and I teach you how to put systems and strategies in place every day to activate that, to amplify that. Because it's not a decision that you just make once for yourself to be all of you and to be fully expressed. We really do need to support ourselves in going against the grain, in choosing to activate all of who we are. This is a process and it is something that you can be taught, but it is also something that you need to be supported with. And if you do this for 6 weeks, it just completely transforms the way you think about yourself, the way you experience yourself, and the way you experience the world. And you have the added bonus of finally understanding how to use movement and nutrition to support you in manifesting the goals you have for how you want to look, how you want to feel, how you want to relate to your body. It's a really powerful experience. And if this is something that interests you, I really do urge you to take some time. I've written a whole page of information about what is included. And if you feel compelled to say, yes, I need this for myself, I want more of this conversation, more of this support, more of this kind of cracking open, then I would love you to get in contact with me and we can discuss whether this is the right program for you and how we can get you on board. All right, my loves, thank you so much for your energy, for your time today. I've really loved being able to present to you. If you haven't been able to see this live and you're watching it on replay, let me know. I love knowing who has swung by and spent some time with me. And of course, if you have any questions or you heard anything in this for yourself today that you want to kind of just explore, expand on, continue a conversation about, you can find me on Instagram at Lena_Moxon and my inbox is always open to you. All right, my loves. How'd we go for time? Pretty good. I am notorious for going over time, so I've done well today. Thank you so much for joining me and I will see you next week.